just always, and she's just like, just, oh, I just realized this, my black shirt and then the black dresser, it kind of just looks like I'm a floating head. Oh. I have fun. But yeah, Lydia is annoying, and she's also just not very enthusiastic when you ask her to hold some stuff for you. She's like, I'm sworn to carry your burdens. And it's like, Lydia, we have fun. It's like that line in Avatar, The Last Airbender. They're like, Zuko, typically we like to start our adventures with a more upbeat attitude. In my previous game, I had this witch person. Similar names. It's like they're just recycling the same seven letters. She was pretty cool. I was focusing more on two-handed weapons then, and she was a magician, so it worked out well. This time, while I do focus a lot on magic, I also focus a lot on archery because, like I said, I like to strategize. Helps me beat dungeons that are way beyond my level, because I'll go and I'll be sneaking and I'll hit them and then I'll pull back, and Lydia will be the bait and distract them because she has just no chill and she'll just go after it, and I'll just back up and then I'll creep back in and they'll be distracted fighting her, and while they're distracted I'm just like shooting arrows at them and magic, and they just do nothing to me. So that's nice. And eventually they come after me. So I just run all the way to like near the beginning almost. And I just wait for them one by one. And then I'll hit them a few times. And then I'll run past them and I'll run back to the room where they were in, because it's now empty because they were following me. And I just do that. I just hit them a few times and then I run. Yep, and I just go back and forth, slowly killing them. I like that they don't just like slowly regain their health if you leave them alone, like in World of Warcraft, for example. Makes it so much easier. Yeah, so that's what I like to do. And like I said, trying to focus on magic. But also some archery, but also like a little bit of two-handed weapons. I usually use that as a last resort if like there's nowhere to escape and they're right there. And yeah, I'm just always like switching my armor between magic and fighting. My fighting like armor is stronger, so because they're right there and I want to be protected if they're like there. But then I'll switch to like necromancer robes if I'm doing magic, because it makes my magicka regenerate 75% faster, so that's nice. I really like when I'm going on a quest and I'm heading toward where I need to go. On your compass, you'll see little icons for landmarks that are near you. in danger. So I would always just like wimp out and run back to town, and they would just chase me all the way to town. And I realized that there was a bridge that separated the two halves of the town, and they wouldn't follow me over the bridge. So I would like fail, and they would run, and they would kill everyone on that side of town. And then they'd go back, and then I'd go and I'd loot all the townspeople and try again and fail. And I was like, "Dad, do this for me." And he was like, "You need to learn how to do it." And it's like, I loved Pokemon, but Pokemon is a turn-based in a way that's not like, it doesn't feel like you're being attacked. So that's something that slowly got better over time. But so I guess with Skyrim, the second run through, I'm less stressed out. Mostly I'm just yelling at Lydia. I use like a few cheat codes too. Like, Lydia's always getting like stuck on things and lost. Like, I'll just be going around and I'll be like, "Where the heck is Lydia?" It's like, "Where are you? How could you possibly..."